Okay, so Project 2025. Now, this is something that's been coming around in past couple of years, and it's really bad, apparently. It's a set of fascist policies. If Trump gets back in, it's going to destroy American democracy. It's going to dismantle the whole system, and people are going to be fucked if this gets through. So there is an actual big massive manifesto. It's like 920 pages long. This is too much to read. Too small in print. Too much waffle. This page I'm looking at now is from Democracy Forward, the People's Guide to Project 2025. It gets straight to the point. It's going to tell you what's going to happen if this comes to pass. And as you might have guessed, this actually opposes Project 2025, as you should all. So, Project 2025 is among the most profound threats to the American people and possibly the world. We read Project 2025's entire 900 plus page mandate for leadership so that you don't have to. Wow. Yeah, it's probably like being like a novel, but fine. What we discovered was a systemic, ruthless plan to undermine the quality of life of millions of Americans, remove critical protections, and dismantle programs for communities across the nation, and prioritize special interests and ideological extremism over people. From attacking overtime pay, student loans, and reproductive rights, to allowing more discrimination, pollution, and price gouging, those behind Project 2025 are preparing to go to incredible lengths to create a country only for some, not for all of us. For the few, not the many. If these plans are enacted, which Project 2025's authors claim can happen without congressional approval, yeah, because obviously, because they've got this presidential immunity now as well, so that's going to be a factor as well. 4.3 million people could lose overtime protections. 40 million people could have their food assistance reduced. 220,000 American jobs could be lost, and much, much more. The stakes are higher than ever for democracy. And for people. These threats aren't hypothetical. These are the real plans. The Heritage Foundation and the 100 plus organizations that make up, well, 100 plus, but yeah, that make up Project 2025 Advisory Board have mapped out exactly how they will achieve their extreme ends. They aim to try and carry out many of the most troubling proposals through an anti-democratic president and political loyalists installed in the executive branch without waiting for congressional action. How can we do that? Anyway, and while many of these plans are unlawful, winning in court is not guaranteed. Given that some of the same far-right movement that is behind Project 2025 has shaped our current court system. Yeah, like SCOTUS, we need to get rid of them. To combat the threats posed by Project 2025, we have to first understand them and to know about them as well. What follows are some of the most dangerous proposals that make up Project 2025. Specifically, those that we plan to implement through federal agencies and the far-right executive branch. Excuse me. The majority of Americans share the same values and priorities, but Project 2025 wants to push an extreme, out-of-touch agenda on all of us. By reading this guide and sharing it, we can begin to address these threats and go on offense towards building a bold, inclusive democracy for all people. Okay? So firstly, what is Project 2025? The Project 2025 Presidential Transition Project is a well-funded, eight-figure effort of the Heritage Foundation and more than 100 organisations to enable a future anti-democratic presidential administration to take swift, far-right action that would cut wages for working people, dismantle social safety net programmes, reverse decades of progress for civil rights, more like centuries, redefine the way our society operates and undermine our economy. Excuse me. A central pillar of Project 2025 is the Mandate for Leadership, a 900-plus page policy playbook authored by former Trump administration officials and other extremists that provide a radical vision for our nation and a roadmap to implement it. Project 2025 snapshot. Proposals from Project 2025 discussed in detail throughout this guide that they claim could be implemented through executive branch alone, so without new legislation, include cut overtime protection for 4.3 million workers, stop efforts to lower prescription drug prices. Yeah, that would be stupid. Drugs, medications would be free. Limit access to food assistance. Why? With an average of more than 40 million people in 21.6 million households rely on monthly. Yeah. Eliminate the Head Start Early Education Program. That's what that is. Which serves over 1 million children annually. Cut American Rescue Plan ARP programs that have created or saved 220,000 jobs. Restrict access to medication abortion. You want to get rid of that anyway with Roe v. Wade, which they've scrapped. Push more of 33 million people enrolled in Medicare towards Medicare Advantage and, other worse, private options. Expose the 368,000 children in foster care to risk of increased discrimination. Deny students in 25 states and Washington, D.C. access to student loans because their state provides in-state tuition to undocumented immigrants. Fuck off. So just because there's some immigrants there, you're just going to take access from everyone else. Everyone else gets punished. And what's wrong with immigrants anyway? Roll back civil rights protections across multiple fronts, including cutting diversity, equity, and inclusion-related DEI programs and LGBTQ plus rights in healthcare, education, and workplaces. All right, the plans. Firstly, cut wages, create unsafe workplaces, and destabilize our economy. Project 2025 would enable corporations to cut overtime pay, relax worker safety rules, allow workplace discrimination, and more. Learn more here. Yeah. Okay, got a new page. Okay. Cut wages, create unsafe workplaces, and destabilize our economy. Project 2025 would enable corporations to cut overtime pay, relax worker safety rules, allow workplace discrimination, and more. One, stop people from earning overtime pay. Project 2025 wants the Department of Labor to make it harder for people to earn overtime pay. Well, if you work longer hours, then much harder, you should have overtime pay. And raise minimum wage and that. In 2024, the Biden administration issued a policy that will make over 4 million workers newly eligible to qualify for overtime pay. The US Department of Labor did this by raising the overtime threshold. Department of Labor, I'm guessing that's like our DWP. Which is the salary ceiling under which salaried workers still qualify and automatically for overtime pay if they work more than 40 hours in a week. But yeah, that's a lot in itself, even though those workers are not paid hourly. Oh, fucking hell. Yeah. which they should be paid hourly. Good money. Raising the overtime threshold increases the number of workers with guaranteed overtime protections. Currently, the threshold protects non-hourly workers. What do you mean by that? Who make up to 43,880 annually, and it's set to rise again in 2025 to apply to people making up to 58,656. Project 2025 doesn't want to raise this threshold. Instead, Project 2025 proposes lowering the threshold and taking away overtime eligibility, can't even say the word, for millions of workers. Shocking. This would leave at least 4 million working people in industries that pay annually, but still at lower wages, stuck on working long hours without overtime pay. Yeah, even just working normal hours, minimum wage, that's hard enough. Need more money. Everything from hospitality to manufacturing, administrative roles, and more. Two, cut funding for local job creating programs. Project 2025 proposes to destroy a program that plays a pivotal role in facilitating transformative economic growth for local economies. The Economic Development Administration, EDA, was responsible for investing billions of ARP dollars to transformative infrastructure plan projects across the nation. According to the 2022 report, these investments resulted in 220,000 jobs and generated nearly $20 billion in private investment. Project 2025 proposes that the EDA grants should be consolidated with other programs and/or eliminated, which would undermine the ability of a federal government to invest in communities across the nation, with effects that could devastate working people, small businesses, and the overall health of our economy. Three, manipulate data that businesses rely on to keep our economy functioning. Functioning, by consolidating the Bureau of Economic Analysis, Census Bureau, and Bureau of Labor Statistics, Project 2025 would kneecap the data collection capacities of these important agencies, with effects felt by working people across the nation. Data compiled by the US Bureau of Labor Statistics, BLS, is intentionally independent from partisan interests, as it should be, and is frequently relied on by the public, employers, researchers, and government organizations. According to BLS, they measure employment, compensation, worker safety, productivity, and price movements. This information is used by job seekers, workers, business leaders, and others to help them make sound decisions at work and at home. Project 2025, however, wants to consolidate the US Bureau of Economic Analysis and Census Bureau with BLS into one agency. Excuse me. While formal reorganization requires explicit delegation from Congress to go through, the Trump administration made an attempt in 2018 to bypass Congress and use other executive powers to do so. Attempted to, but we didn't manage to do it, did we? Good. Hope we don't manage again. If an extremist were to occupy the executive branch again, Project 2025 would want them to go even further. Yeah. And to go through properly. Going to make sure it doesn't happen. Politicizing BLS and reducing the data collection capacity of the agency by consolidating it into the Census Bureau would make it harder to know how our economy is doing, whether families' paychecks are growing, and what steps may need to take to make small businesses are thriving and business people have enough in their bank accounts to make ends meet. Yeah. Really bad. Four, weaken child labor protections. Project 2025 would amend hazard regulations to allow employers to put young people into unsafe working conditions. Yeah, that's bad. That's like what DWP here do. Make you found fit for work, just go to any old job. They don't give a fuck. And this one doesn't give a fuck either. The authors of Project 2025 think that young people should be able to work in inherently dangerous jobs. Not really. Not if they're cut up for it. or disabled or what have you, in roles that are currently not permitted due to insignificant safety concerns that have long been established and enforced by the US Department for Labor. Project 2025 would change DLO, DOL policies and would allow American youth to work these jobs, meaning young people entering the labor force out of economic necessity could be subjected to more dangerous work because they need the income more than others and cannot access a safer job or get this pay as well. Yeah, it's really bad. So that's it for the this section. Next section. Make it harder for Americans to make ends meet. And for that other one, yeah, it's going to be really hard for young people and the economy and what have you, to make people struggle more with money. It's not good for disabled people either. Anyway, a strong democracy is one where people have the resources they need to thrive, not worry about how they will make ends meet. Excuse me? Yeah. Project 2025 proposals would only make daily life harder for people, with fewer people able to access food assistance and affordable early education, less support for veterans with disabilities, and cuts to support for farmers. Right. Restrict access to food assistance. Project 2025 would make it harder for people to access food assistance by adding ineffective requirements and re-evaluating the important programs. Why would you do that, though, and how are you going to do it? According to research from the US Department of Agriculture, 86% of all Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, SNAP, SNAP, benefits go to households that include a child, elderly person, or person with disabilities, and 92% of all SNAP benefits go to households with income of or at below, with income at or below the federal poverty line. The Thrifty Food Plan plays an important role in ensuring recipients of food assistance are able to access food that composes a balanced and nutritious diet. In tandem, the Biden administration has increased food assistance to outlay to account for increased costs associated with more nutritious foods. Project 2025 wants to reverse course and reimpose ineffective work requirements, which recent studies have shown do not actually increase employment, but do still drive down the number of people who use food assistance onto SNAP and re-evaluate the 50 food plan. Does America have food banks like what we do? Not sure, but yeah, everyone needs to eat and have the money to get food as well. 2, eliminate the Head Start program. Project 2025 would destroy a program that is critical to uplifting children across the nation from lower socioeconomic backgrounds. Head Start is a critical program that helps over 1 million children across the nation become ready for school by providing them with mental, emotional, and social support programming. This program provides targeted assistance to low-income children as an important method to bridge inequities and ensure that all children receive a solid foundation as they embark on their educational journey. Project 2025 proposes to eliminate the program. Okay. Without Head Start, families who are already struggling financially could experience even greater economic burdens as they would have to spend more on childcare and education and healthcare, as that's shit as well. It's going to make even more shit. Problem, as it already is. Limit which disabilities qualify veterans for benefits. Again, trying to do the same with the DWP here, are they? The authors of Project 2025 think too many veterans qualify for disability benefits. What gives you the right to say who qualifies for the benefits or not? Huh? Disability benefits often crucial core lifelines of veterans who became disabled as a result of a military service and disabled people in general, veterans or not, and can be the difference between a veteran being able to put food on the table or not. That's right. Project 2025 proposes to have a US Department of Veterans Affairs cut costs by having fewer health conditions qualify veterans with disability benefits. But yeah. A proposal could greatly restrict disabled veterans' access to life-sustaining benefits. Yeah, just like the DWP here, trying to find people fit for work, trying to mess with work capability assessments, PIP assessments. And both of those together help a lot. I'm not sure what it's like in America, but yeah. 4, remove safety nets of farmers. Project 2025 thinks that farmers are receiving too much assistance. The people who put food on our tables and ensure our communities get fed are often subject to the whims of unpredictable weather patterns and market conditions. This means while some years a farmer may be doing great, the next they could be on the brink of economic failure. That's where safety net comes in. Project 2025 wants to restrict safety nets for farmers to unusual situations, even though we know that the difficult conditions farmers experience are not unusual but common. A restriction of assistance to farmers would disparately impact low-income farmers and those without extensive assets to fall back on when things go airy. All right. 5, eliminate funding for key public transportation projects. Despite its transformational investment in communities across the US, the Capital Investment Grants CRD program is a Project 2025 target for elimination. Yeah, like here, we've hardly got any public transport. We have buses, but not very lots of times, not very regular. I mean, you might miss some, but two come at once. Some are like every half hour or whatever. It's stupid. Despite its transformational investment in communities across the US, the Capital Investment Grants Program, CRG program, is a Project 2025 target for elimination. The CRG program plays an important role in awarding federal grants to local communities in order to fund infrastructure projects. After the bipartisan infrastructure law was passed in 2021, CRG was responsible for awarding billions of dollars for key public transportation projects across the country. Project 2025 wants to eliminate CRG, which can make it much harder for Americans without cars to get to work and travel around town, to work or just to be family and friends. So what's the point of just getting rid of it all? What do you get to gain from it? Right. Restrict reproductive rights and access to healthcare. Despite the majority of Americans supporting comprehensive healthcare and reproductive freedom, Project 2025 would prefer a far different reality. Their attacks would undermine Medicare, keep prescription drug prices high, and restrict access to reproductive care. Yeah, you need like Medicare for all, like proper NHS. Keep the cost of life-saving medication too high. It's already really high, just healthcare in general in America. Project 2025 would undo Medicare's new ability to negotiate lower prescription price for sales, seniors. Medicare's new ability to negotiate low prescription drug prices for seniors established through the Inflation Reduction Act, IRA. Different IRA. Will be transformative for millions of seniors in the United States. Fancy having that acronym, Irish Republican Army. According to the Center for American Progress, these negotiations are targeting some of the most expensive drugs frequently served by seniors, saving hundreds of thousands of dollars in drugs costs each year. You need to scrap it all together, because healthcare system is shit in America. Even just to see a doctor, you need to pay. These negotiations are often critical for advanced health equity, given that many other prescriptions targeted by the negotiations treat conditions disparately experienced by people who have historically experienced marginalization because of their race or gender. And probably sexuality as well. While Project 2025's plan is to specifically instruct Congress to repeal this part of the IRA, they could also easily advise the Department of Justice, DOJ, to stop defending Medicare's ability to negotiate drug prices in courts. Are you really going to stop them defending it? What if they tell you to fuck off and just continue defending it? Stop them defending drug prices in courts. Yeah, where the program currently faces numerous challenges. Project 2025 attack on Medicare's ability to negotiate drug prices would impact millions of elderly Americans, as it already does, and just people in general, particularly elderly people of colour and those with low incomes. End Medicaid and abortion use, or make it incredibly difficult to access. Project 2025 would provoke approval from the US Food and Drug Administration, FDA, criminalising mailing medication abortion. Yeah, we want to get rid of abortion, don't they? Probably Roe v. Wade, which would be abolished. Or even enlist the US Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, as part of our anti-abortion efforts. This one's a bit long, I think, yeah. Over two decades of medical practice showed up. I don't know how you say that. Mifepristone, how do you say that? Medication abortion is safe and effective. In fact, just last year, nearly two-thirds of all pregnant people relied on medication abortion for their abortion care. This is one of the last lifelines for millions of pregnant people across the United States, as many state governments are ramping up attacks. The anti-abortion extremists behind 2025, not content with merely overturning Roe v. Wade, want to attack access to medication abortion nationwide by any means necessary. Project 2025 would weaponize the long dormant Comstock Act, whatever that is, to try and make the delivery of medication abortion by mail illegal. Originally passed in the 19th century, that long ago, to restrict the types of things that could be mailed, the Comstock Act is today, in District Court Judge Will Robert Chambers' own words, a widely obligated 19th century statute. Despite the DOJ, the courts, and the Congress already making it clear that the Comstock Act does not apply to legal abortion care, Project 2025 plans to weaponize the DOJ and resurrect this act to ban nationwide medication abortion access. Project 2025 would have the FDA reverse approval of the safe and effective medication. Reversing federal approval of medication abortion could deprive people of essential health care, even in states where abortion remains legal. In states where abortion is banned or restricted, this would further subject people to the whims of state legislators, many of which have actively pushed or enacted abortion restrictions since the Supreme Court overturned Roe v. Wade, and they need to bring that back. Project 2025 would further undermine medication abortion by mail by reimposing unnecessary and burdensome requirements like mifepristone, however you say it again, but yeah, be dispensed in person and by a doctor. Post Dobbs, the FDA has played an important role by allowing the distribution of mifepristone by mail and at certain pharmacies. This has allowed increased access to care, given that not everyone has the privilege of convenient in-person doctor access. If these plans are implemented, it will become harder for everyone to access abortion care, particularly low-income pregnant people and those in rural communities. If all those fails, Project 2025 would turn to EPA to apply restrictive regulations to medication abortion. Project 2025 wants an anti-democratic president to direct the EPA to classify medication abortion as containing forever chemicals, which are subject to stricter regulations. If the EPA were to classify medication abortion as a forever chemical, it would stifle the approval and distribution of medication abortion. Yeah, that's bad. And so I just want a quick note. If you've ever seen Dirty Dancing, there's a character in there called Penny, who has an illegal abortion, which is the main reason why the baby gets together with Johnny, because of the abortion. But yeah, that would probably come to pass in real life if this comes to pass. Anyway, push people towards private Medicare plans that worsen health conditions. It's already private. Oh, but yes, what did I do that? Under the guise of allowing greater choice, Project 2025 would push policies that favour private worth performing alternatives to Medicare. You need to bring back you need to bring Medicare or NHS, get rid of all these private places. While many of Project 2025 plans for Medicare require congressional action, we also encourage a future administration to use all possible levers, including the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, CMS, to alter this critical program however they can. Several of their proposals would push towards private Medicare alternatives, which are not real alternatives at all, with a report showing that Medicare Advantage plans would threaten rural hospitals and patients and misled people into signing up for them. While Project 2025 may pitch these Medicare reforms as encouraging consumer choice, in reality, they will leave seniors worse off across the country, putting the health of many of the 33 million people enrolled in traditional Medicare at risk. Mm-hmm. And the last one on this section, make it easier for extremists to access personal information about patients' reproductive care. Yeah, that's going to be really bad. Start doxing and what have you. Project 2025 would remove protections for Biden administration put in place post-Dobbs to protect the personal information of people who receive reproductive care. Yeah, what about GDPR? Does that not apply in America? Data protection, that. In the immediate aftermath of a Dobbs decision that overturned Roe v. Wade, the Biden administration issued HIPAA guidance to ensure doctors and other medical providers and health plans know that with limited exceptions, they are not required, and in many cases are not permitted, to disclose patients' private information, including to law enforcement. Yes, that's private, isn't it? It's confidentiality. The administration later finalised a rule to shield the medical records of patients from criminal investigations if they cross state lines to seek an abortion where it is illegal. Even as extremists in Texas actively try to use the courts to access information about people receiving abortions out of state, Project 2025 claims that the Biden administration's privacy guidance is fear-mongering and would have a future administration withdraw it. And it's safety as well. Safety for people who want to get an abortion. From the extremists who will go after them. Disgusting. As more states need to pass increasingly severe efforts to criminalise abortion, this would put medical providers and all pregnant people at increased risk. Yeah. The next up is enable discrimination across society. Threatened by decades of progress in advancing civil rights and equality for all, the authors of Project 2025 want to create a country that allows for more discrimination where we live, study, work and play, and roll back hard-fought victories by our movements of progress. So one, embolden racial discrimination in everything from housing to education to employment. Yeah, we've already got races anyway. Project 2025 proposes that the president should remove a key tool that the federal government uses to enforce civil rights protections. That should be safe to say anyway. Civil rights should be kept. You can't take it away. The ECHR and that EU as well. Project 2025 proposes that the federal government stop the long-standing use of disparate impact in assessing discrimination by ending its use in discrimination cases and even bringing lawsuits that challenge the standards constitutionality. Yeah. The disparate impact standard has long been used in determining discrimination under Title 6 and Title 7 of the Civil Rights Act of 1964 and the Fair Housing Act of 1968. It is important for evaluation and facially neutral programs have disparate impact on certain groups of people. The Civil Rights Division of the DOJ determines disparate impacts as does the adverse effect of a policy or practice fall disproportionately on a race, colour or national origin group. This standard provides an important remedy for the DOJ and others to bring civil rights cases when groups of other people have the right civil rights violated in areas such as employment discrimination and fair housing. So discontinuing its use will make it harder for the federal government to enforce civil rights protections in everything from housing to education to employment. And probably just general life in general. Disparate impact standards have long been ruled constitutional by the United States Supreme Court. So Project 2025 attempts are baseless. Oh, the Supreme Court is fucked now. It's all far right. Make it harder for historically under-resourced communities to access Medicaid, Head Start and other government programs. Population counts can be essential to groups receiving appropriations and resources from the federal government, like Medicaid, Head Start, community mental health programs, and much more. So Project 2025 plans to undercount or undermine the accuracy of these counts would hurt communities that have been economically marginalized. The special interests behind Project 2025 want to reverse the long-standing body of work by civil rights activists who have encouraged the federal government to collect more sophisticated data when it comes to racial and ethnic groups, which has helped ensure communities that have been historically under-resourced because of their racial demographics receive the proper allocation of resources. As recently as March 2024, the Biden administration issued a revision to Statistical Directive No. 15, which governs standards for maintaining, collecting and presenting federal data on race and ethnicity. The revision is a far more accurate and useful state and ethnicity data collection across various agencies of the US federal government. Project 2025 would advise a future administration to hamstring these revisions by instructing the White House Office of Management and Budget to reverse them and ensure that other federal agencies are not aiding in the collection of more accurate data. This would leave historically underrepresented communities at a disadvantage when it comes to accessing critical programs we rely on every day, from Medicaid to Head Start. Undermine gender equity across the government. Project 2025 would eliminate the White House Gender Policy Council, which is key to promoting our contraception access, gender-based violence prevention, and women's health equity. Under the Biden administration, the White House Gender Policy Council has led efforts to increase access to contraception, published the National Plan to End Gender-Based Violence, and begun groundbreaking research into how women's health is studied across the country. Project 2025 would immediately disband the council and prioritise coordinated efforts that push for promoting life and emphasise a narrow vision of what defines a family. A man and a woman and what have you. Allow more discrimination against LGBTQ plus youth in adoption and foster care agencies. Project 2025 would make it easier for state and child welfare agencies, which are charged by the public to provide appropriate care for children, to cite religious exemptions as a way to promote bigotry. Yeah. In 2022, more than 368,000 children were enrolled into foster care in the US. Project 2025 would instruct the Department of Health and Human Services to repeal a 2016 regulation that provides additional protection for foster youth related to sexual orientation and gender identity, enabling adoption of foster care agencies to subject vulnerable children to the whims of extreme religious beliefs would be detrimental to the physical, mental and emotional health of fostered adopted youth, especially LGBTQ plus youth, who are already dealing with intense adversities. Yet, there's a lot we can say about that. And partly why I won't have anything to do with my family, because they're homophobic and what have you. Put black communities and others that have historically borne the brunt of health impacts and pollution and other environmental harms at an increased risk. Project 2025 proposes to eliminate the EPA's Council Office of Environmental Justice and External Civil Rights. Excuse me. EPA, newly created Office of Environmental Justice and External Civil Rights, is the agency's dedicated office for ensuring that environmental and public health policies are crafted and implemented in ways that ensure no communities are left behind or disproportionately harmed. Eliminating this office would put the communities that have historically borne the brunt of harms from pollution climate change and other hazards, which are too often black and brown communities at increased risk. Yep. If you don't care about, if you want to make it a white pea country, a white man's religious country. It's disgusting. Enable discrimination based on sexual orientation and gender identity. Yeah. By misinterpreting Supreme Court precedent and allowing more religious exemptions, Project 2025 would roll back protections against discrimination against LGBTQ plus people and others in the workplace. LGBTQ plus Americans have had to fight for protections in the law. And in recent years, we have witnessed important gains, including the Supreme Court's confirmation of federal protections in the workplace, which logically extend to other areas like healthcare and schools. Yet Project 2025 wants to reverse this progress. Project 2025 plans to restrict its application of a critical 2020 Supreme Court case called Bostock v. Clayton County. That assures workplace protection for LGBTQ plus people through making clear that discrimination against LGBTQ plus people is a form of sex discrimination prohibited by our federal civil rights laws. Project 2025 would try to enable greater workplace discrimination through allowing employers to impose their religious or moral beliefs on the employees. Yeah, like religious freedom. It's disgusting. Additionally, the Biden administration has helped ensure protections from gender identity discrimination across many aspects of their lives, including healthcare, housing, education, credit and lending services, and community safety programs. Project 2025, however, would roll back and then severely limit these protections and leave already vulnerable people at increased risk for discrimination when trying to rent an apartment, go to school, and more. That's got bigger. Okay, how much time have we got? One, two, three, four, five. Okay, we've got five more chapters to go. We get in there. Where did we go? Where did it get up to? We'll set polluters loose and undo climate change action. We've waited decades for meaningful and robust federal action to combat climate change and protect people from the harms of pollution. Project 2025 couldn't care less about these threats, and now they want to destroy your hard-fought gains. Yeah, they couldn't care less about anyone. One, make our air dirtier and worse than climate change, as if it's all not already bad enough. Project 2025 and make it even harder for the EPA to take action against climate change by attacking the endangerment finding. Much of what the EPA does is to tie to the endangerment finding, which, according to the Natural Resources Defense Council, NRDC, requires the EPA to take action under the Clean Air Act to curb emissions of carbon dioxide, methane, and four other heat-trapping air pollutants from vehicles, power plants, and other industries. Project 2025, however, wants to establish a system to update the 2009 endangerment finding. According to NRDC, updating the endangerment finding means restricting the federal government's funding mandate to combat climate change in order to advance the public health and welfare of the American people and our lands. If Project 2025 was successful in getting the federal government to update the endangerment finding, it could become much harder for the EPA under the Clean Air Act to take measures to combat greenhouse gases, emissions, pollution, and other harmful effects of climate change. Oh, yeah. Cut off weather, ocean, and climate data by disbanding NOAA. Project 2025 would disband the National Oceanographic and Atmospheric Administration, which provides critical weather data and insightful scientific research. The National Oceanographic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, has played a critical role in helping us understand the effects of human behavior on the world's oceans and atmosphere. NOAA issues daily weather forecasts, severe storm warnings, and more. It also monitors for climate and manages fisheries and restores coastal environments and supports marine commerce. According to NOAA, the agency's products and services support economic vitality and affect more than one third of America's gross domestic product. Additionally, NOAA's reports have made more important discoveries about the effects of climate change. NOAA's expertise is frequently relied on by other federal agencies to understand how they can respond and adapt to climate change. The proposal to disband NOAA would leave federal agencies unequipped to combat climate change, not to mention deprive scientists, businesses, and the public of key data. Transfer environment funding away from mission-based entities to state regulators, who in many cases do not support sustainable policies. It wouldn't surprise me. Project 2025 seeks to undo progress made through the Inflation Reduction Act, IRA, by any means necessary. The IRA creates ambitious and expansive investment in climate action and infrastructure development, and is a top target of Project 2025. Even without new legislation, Project 2025 advocates to shift climate-related IRA funds away from mission-based organisations with subject matter expertise and towards state regulatory entities. This would, in our estimation, allow state leaders not committed to climate sustainability or those who deny climate change altogether to misuse funds in a way that would set back climate action. Yeah, a lot of them do deny climate change for all conspiracy theorists. They don't care. Expand offshore oil and natural gas drilling on public lands and waters. Project 2025 would just push the Department of the Interior to allow oil and natural gas lease sales to maximise export permitted. Yeah, whew. A lot of reading. It's not as bad as the 900 odd document, but yeah, it's still getting there. The groups behind the mandate for leadership want to conduct offshore oil and natural gas lease sales to maximise extent permitted. The section of a mandate for leadership was written by William Perry Pendley, a former Trump administration official who had to rescue himself from dozens of matters before the Bureau of Land Management while he was leading it. Due to flagrant conflicts of interest as a former president of a special interest organisation that called for the widespread transfer of federal public lands to private holders. Not only that, Pendley has referred to climate science as junk science and likened the existence of climate change to unicorns. Yeah. Yeah, you're just a twat. This proposal would allow fossil fuel companies to drill on more public lands and waters. Disgusting. Undoing progress made by the current administration to decrease this harmful practice. Yeah. Bad. And that's it for that one, I think. Yeah. Make education unaffordable and unwelcoming. Our public schools are foundational to our democracy. When special interests undermine public schools, they undermine the ability of students from all backgrounds to learn, feel safe in their community, and develop skills and knowledge that enable students to thrive. If Project 2025 has their way, our public schools could be stripped of funding, protections for students, and high-quality curricula. Cut federal loan programs that help parents, college students, graduate students, and immigrants afford higher education. Project 2025 would roll back federal student loan programs that are critical to ensuring higher education is not reserved to only the wealthy and well-connected. Yeah. Everyone deserves education. It needs to be free. Same here. Education is a right for everyone. Free education for all. As the cost of higher education soars into the country, accessible and stable student loans are a critical way to ensure that people from all backgrounds can access higher education. The special interests behind Project 2025 want to kneecap the federal government provision of student loans, taking away the ability of parents of college students to take out the parent plus loans, graduate students to take out graduate plus loans, and undocumented immigrants to take out federal loans entirely. This would devastate the futures of millions of college students. So what about those already studying in the middle of it? They would also deny loan access to students at schools that provide in-state tuition to undocumented immigrants. This means students in 25 states and Washington, D.C. will not be able to access student loans. Yeah, that's bad. Make public schools even more dangerous for LGBTQ plus students. Project 2025 would have a Secretary of Education remove a host of protections for LGBTQ plus students of school in schools. Public schools are already dangerous for LGBTQ plus students across the nation, especially LGBTQ plus students of colour. Project 2025 would make matters even worse by directing the future Secretary of Education to resign the Biden administration's expanded Title IX protections for LGBTQ plus students and reinstate the regressive rules previously imposed by the Trump administration. Project 2025 emphasised that any definition of sex under Title IX should mean only biological sex assigned at birth. These actions threaten to put transgender, non-binary and gender non-conforming students at risk, yeah, particularly when their gender identity does not correspond with their sex assigned at birth. Push ideology onto funding for international business programs. Project 2025 wants to dictate what students learn in higher education by disproportionately funding programs that push for an ideological agenda that they agree with. Not what the students agree with. In trying to dictate what people can and cannot learn, the special interest authors behind Project 2025 want to direct funding to international business programs that teach their preferred subjects. Well, like Christianity, what have you? With nearly half, at minimum, of Department of Education funding going to these programs. These programs are geared towards providing students a better understanding of markets across the world in all different forms. Make it easy for charter schools to discriminate against LGBTQ plus students. Project 2025 would loosen data collection requirements for charter schools, undoing recent progress by the Biden administration, which has ensured data collection better includes transgender, non-binary and gender non-conforming students. Data collection that better includes people across gender identities and sexual orientations is important for ensuring LGBTQ plus students' civil rights are protected. Yeah. During the Biden administration, the US Department of Education Office of Civil Rights, OCR, has required all charter schools to enhance the accuracy of student demographic data collection by requiring that schools provide non-binary as an option for self-selection. Yeah. Okay. Additionally, in 2021, OCR instructed charter schools to retire a collection of data that presents purely binary depictions of a composition of school sports teams, meaning that data demographics of these teams were relegated to strictly male and female, at the exclusion of non-binary and gender non-conforming students. Project 2025 would advise the Department of Education to rescind these changes and institute a new civil rights data collection instructor that would collect data directly relevant to OCR's authority. In other words, that would mean only the data that Project 2025's authors think they are valid, which excludes LGBTQ plus students. Without this data, it would be hard to know where LGBTQ plus students are experiencing discrimination, allowing it to fester and harm people across the country. Yeah, really bad. Yeah. Undermine. I think I'll be on the last one bit now. Yeah, coming to the end now. Undermine government's ability to deliver for people. Civil servants are federal employees who work and live in all 50 states for more than 2 million people who work to keep our air clean, water safe and consumers protected and mail delivered. Attacks on the nation's civil service are attacks on the government's ability to work for the people. One, replace non-partisan federal employees with partisan loyalists. Project 2025. I would have a future president reissue the Trump administration schedule F executive order to make it easier to fire federal employees. Civil servants deliver our mail, keep our air, water and clear water clean, protect consumers from abuse. President Trump's executive order 13957 Schedule F, attempted to remove critical protections for millions of these federal employees, so it would be easy for him and his cronies to fire them. If Schedule F were to be reinstated, these functions could be in the hands of partisan loyalists instead of qualified experts. Firing civil servants at will simply means they are not hyper-partisan or extreme enough will be a disservice to the millions of Americans who depend on federal workers and the services they deliver every day. Democracy Forward submitted a letter on behalf of 27 organizations in support of the Biden administration's final rule. In addition to other supportive comments that proactively creates additional protections for the nation's civil service and provides an important safeguard against a potential anti-democratic administration. Force career experts out of government by relocating federal agencies. While the vast majority of civil servants already live and work outside of DC, Project 2025 still proposed to relocate DC-based offices in an effort to box out long-serving non-partisan experts. Out of the 2.2 million federal employees, most already do not work in Washington DC. Still, we know that many of our nation's foremost experts in their respective fields are situated in Washington DC, serving the American people every day at federal agencies. In 2019, the Trump administration relocated the Bureau of Land Management, BLM, to Colorado, resulting in 77% of the Bureau's employees resigning from their positions. If federal agencies are relocated without thoughtful consideration and public input, critical agencies could lose major sects of the labor force, limiting the ability of a federal government to deliver for the people it's meant to serve. A minister ideologically biased or discriminatory tests for federal workers. Project 2025 would issue problematic civil service tests for prospective federal employees. The special interests behind Project 2025 want to create their own pipeline for important roles within our federal government, and they've already created a personnel database for those who would like to be considered for positions during a future administration. Registration for this database includes a questionnaire which evaluates candidates through ideological bias questions. They would also utilize legislative or regulatory processes, including through the Office of Personnel Management, to reinstate the uses of general intelligence tests which have not been used since the Carter administration. At the time, civil rights groups contended that the general intelligence exam, the professional and administration career exam, or PACE, used to hire for certain agency positions were discriminatory. After a class action lawsuit alleging employment discrimination led to a consent decree, Carter administration officials abolished the use of them exam for hiring. Judging prospective candidates for federal employment in ideological or discriminatory ways is a dangerous way to govern. People across the US depend on federal employees every day, and replacing experts with partisan loyalists would be a tremendous disservice. Four, meddle with national security by altering security clearances. Project 2025 removes civil servants, security clearances, and politicize the granting of clearances. Why would you even remove access for? Security clearances are typically revoked according to a form process that does not provide some due processing rights for those whose clearances are revoked. Project 2025, however, would encourage a future administration to remove IC employees under vague criteria that risk increased politicization. In addition to revoking clearances, Project 2025 would empower the Director of National Intelligence and the Director of the Central Intelligence Agency, CIA, to expedite the issuance of security clearances to those deemed necessary to meet the administration's mission needs. Expediting the issuance of security clearances paves the way for more unqualified and inept leaders to be charged with our nation's most sensitive national security matters. Take Jared Kushner. When two national expert security specialists refused to issue him a clearance due to concerns of foreign influence over him, the Trump administration overruled the expertise and gave him one anyway. Really. But if it's normal people, they would just take it away. So the threats of Project 2025 do not end here. This People's Guide only begins to catalogue the people and the communities who would be harmed if a future presidential administration began to implement Project 2025's proposals. Businesses and industry across the country could be harmed not just from the lack of data collection discussed above, but also from proposals to politicise the Federal Reserve or to restrict free trade. Our country's national security itself is threatened by proposals to concentrate military decision-making. Further undermine our intelligence agencies or promote isolationist policies. We continue to analyse the policies and the harm to people and expect to release updated versions of a People's Guide. Well, we report on the threats that would make it harder to run a business and put our security and more. Yeah, so yeah, that's it. That's Project 2025. Sorry about that. Was so much reading. Not as much as the actual main 25. So there's some lot of reading. I was just trying to struggle reading some words. I was kind of dozing out a bit. Yeah, that's it. So yeah, Project this must not get through to Parliament. If Trump gets in, all this is going to pass. Which is why you must not vote Trump. Don't vote for Trump. Don't vote for Project 2025. So yeah. America's fucked if this comes through. All the services, public for everyone, they're going to be scrapped for whatever reason. So yeah. So there you go.